Hello everybody, my name is Jean-Philippe Girard. I am a researcher at the CNRS at the University of Toulouse in the southwest of France. And today it's my great pleasure to present our paper recently published in the Journal of Experimental Medicine. This is a study about allergic airway inflammation. As you know, the environment plays an important role in allergic disease. The pollen, the mold, the fungi that are present in the air are important factors. And in the lab, we are particularly interested by a major fungal allergen that is called Alternaria alternata. This is a major aeroallergen that has been linked to the severity of asthma, asthma death, and epidemic asthma, also called thunderstorm asthma, in many different parts of the world. For we ask the question, how this allergen, Alternaria alternata, initiates allergic inflammation in the airways. And what we found is that very soon after a single exposure to this allergen Alternaria alternata in naive mice, epithelial cells released alarmins, IL-33 and TL1A. IL-33, interleukin 33, this was already known. Actually, we discovered IL-33 here in Toulouse 20 years ago as a nuclear factor of endothelial cells. And later we demonstrated that it functioned as a nuclear alarmin. What is really new in the current study is the identification of TL1A, TNF-like ligand 1A, as a novel epithelial alarmin. We demonstrated that TL1A is constantly expressed in airway epithelial cells, including both type 1 and type 2 alveolar epithelial cells, both in humans and in mice, and also basal cells, including in asthmatic patients. For TL1A is novel epithelial alarmin that cooperates with IL-33 in the initiation of allergic inflammation. Therefore, what they do, what we found, these two alarmins activate ILC2s, type 2 innate lymphoid cells, and they induce huge production of huge amounts of IL-9 together with IL-5 and IL-13. And we observe a transient phenotype that we call the ILC9 phenotype that is characterized by the simultaneous production of large amounts of these three type 2 cytokines that are very important for the initiation of allergic airway inflammation. Why did these findings are important? Because epithelial alarmins, particularly in the lung, are promising therapeutic targets. Antibodies against TSLP and other lung epithelial alarmin are already approved for the treatment of some patients with asthma. Antibodies against IL-33 or its receptor, ST2, are currently in phase 3 clinical trials for COPD, another lung inflammatory disease. And there are currently 6 phase 3 clinical trials targeting the IL-33-ST2 pathway. Therefore, we believe the identification of a novel lung epithelial alarmin, TL1A, is an important finding because this provides a potential novel therapeutic target for asthma and other lung disease. And it is important to mention that antibodies against TL1A are already in clinical trials for inflammatory bowel disease such as Crohn's disease. Therefore, in a couple of years or maybe 5 to 10 years from now, antibodies against TL1A will be hopefully available to treat patients with asthma or other lung inflammatory disease. I thank you for your attention and I wish you a good day.